briefing number 51 on agriculture as an engine of economic reconstruction and development in fragile countries. Thank you very much for the people who also follow live this session. There are many. And as always, you can always pose your comments or inputs to the speakers. We are very happy, I mean, to organize this briefing today, specifically looking at some of the most fragile countries in Africa. And when we say fragile for us, it doesn't mean only political or governance, but it means a combination of the factors which led to a very high and quite long-term fragility, conflict, governance, climate shocks, economic shocks, poverty. So we are specifically, depending, of course, on how you look at fragility, you could end up with a very long list of countries, if not most of African ones. But what we have decided is really to look at the most fragile, as I said, quite a long time. So Somalia, South Sudan, Burundi, DRC, Chad, etc. And of course, you have the Afghanistans and other countries which are not part of the ACP. We would like, of course, to see how fragility affects agriculture, but also how agriculture is part of the solution, because all these countries have quite a large agriculture sector, and it's de facto a part of the solution in the field, but how it could be taken up as part of more investment and more support, be from the development community, be from the private sector. And of course, moving from humanitarian, which is still very important, humanitarian interventions to more sustainable development practices and investment. And we are very glad that, you know, we have people from the policy and development community side and from the practical practice and implementers in the field, specifically coming some of those from those countries like Somalia, but also South Sudan, DRC, Burundi, coming specifically my neighbor. So thank you very much for making that effort, and thank you very much for the development partners like WFP, FAO, World Bank Group to join us, because all actors are important and all involved. So without more delay, just a word, but I think most of you are coming to all briefings, or a big part of them. This is an initiative which we ran from 2007. I'm coordinating on behalf of the organizers, who are the European Commission, specifically DEFCO, the European Development part, the ECP Group, who always welcomes here very warmly, who stands for the Group of African, Caribbean, and Pacific States. And thank you very much, Assistant Secretary General, again, for welcoming us, and Concord, which is the platform of European NGOs, development NGOs across EU member states, and of course CTA, represented by my director here. So without a major delay, you will find all the information online, as always, including not only the web streaming of today, but edited videos and further material to consult. I'm sure that the speakers as well will just keep to their time in the interest of discussions and will help the chairs. Thank you, Bernard, for chairing the first session. So without any delay, Mr. Vivanu Gnassounou, again, thank you very much for welcoming us in this important house here, where you held the committees of ambassadors, the ministerial meetings, and including some heads of state meetings in this same room. You are the Assistant Secretary General in charge of everything which is important, actually, for the agriculture sector. For us, at least, I mean, commodities, trade, food security, and so on, which is a combination of things which matter. But your background is not only expert on commodities and trade, so from the policy side, but also a successful private sector, an entrepreneur, a private sector in the ACP countries and Togo in particular. So thank you very much for being with us, and please.